As the Cold War covered the world with the dark cloud of impending doom, Swedish engineers began a desperate race to produce a revolutionary multi-role fighter capable of fending off any Soviet warplane. With its unique canard design, double delta wing configuration, iconic airframe, and prominent vertical stabilizer, the Saab 37 Viggen aircraft took to the skies looking like a menacing double-winged arrow pointed right at the sun. Blasting through the sound barrier at over Mach 2, powered by a beastly adaptation of the Pratt and Whitney JT8 turbo engine, this fighter flaunted the globe's most remarkable lift-to-drag ratio at daring angles of attack. But what made it extraordinary was that it was the first warplane to carry an airborne digital central computer with integrated circuits for its avionics. No aircraft could elude it, arguably making it the most advanced combat aircraft in Europe when it first took to the skies in June 1971. In the 80s, the Viggen would get a chance to prove its high-tech equipment was not just for show. Over the Europe-Soviet border, one of America's most sophisticated and technologically advanced spy planes, the SR-71 Blackbird had blown one of its engines. Two Viggens scrambled into action, racing against time to intercept and escort the damaged Blackbird. It was do or die. Reach the Blackbird before the Soviets got a chance to blow it out of the sky. Sweden's steadfast dedication to neutrality has demanded a self-sufficient defense game plan. This dogged independence has driven the nation to forge its own path in developing military might, particularly in the skies. The Nordic powerhouse has carved out its niche, crafting warbirds in-house, sidestepping the need to lean on the military machinery of the globe's heavyweights. Swedish warplanes, such as those produced by Saab, including the famous Draken, Viggen, and more recently the Gripen, are known for their quality, reliability, and advanced technology. Sweden has invested heavily in research and development to ensure its warplanes incorporate cutting-edge technology and innovations. This focus on high-tech solutions has allowed Swedish warplanes to remain competitive on a global scale, all while remaining considerably cheaper than other nations' fighter jets. By the 1950s, the nation's design philosophy and reputation were well established. As the Saab's prototype Draken, the world's then most aerodynamically slick fighter, took to the skies for its maiden voyage in 1955, the Swedish Air Force was already piecing together a wish list for the next big thing in their repertoire of innovative airplane design. They were dreaming big and complex, foreseeing a design odyssey that wouldn't bear fruit until well into the swinging 60s. Between the years 1952 and 1957, drawing boards buzzed with the brainstorming sessions of Finnish aircraft wizard Arne Lakoma, exploring a bewildering array of over 100 configurations. Lakoma headed the R&D department and was a living legend in Swedish aircraft design, having started his career fitting captured Soviet engines into old French fighters during the Winter War. His designs ranged from solo to dual engines, embraced both classic and innovative double delta wings, flirted with canard wings, and even gave a nod to the then futuristic vertical takeoff and landing designs, albeit briefly. Right from the get-go, the Viggen broke the mold. It was a comprehensive weapon system, fully integrated and ready to sync up with Sweden's state-of-the-art electronic air defense network, STRIL 60. The primary objective of STRIL 60 was to integrate and modernize Sweden's air defense capabilities. This involved coordinating and controlling various elements within the Air Force, including fighter jets, radar installations, and missile systems. The system was designed to improve Sweden's ability to detect, track, and engage airborne threats, enhancing its overall air defense posture during the Cold War. As part of this larger scheme, the Viggen was intended to serve primarily in a defensive capacity, yet be versatile enough to tackle a broad spectrum of missions and roles. It was intended to perform supersonic dashes at treetop level, and then achieve gentle touchdowns in even the smallest runways. The Viggen had to be able to operate from runways just 500 meters long, a key piece in the Swedish Air Force's chess game of BAS-60, which later evolved into BAS-90. This strategy involved scattering aircraft across a patchwork of wartime bases, ready to spring into action from highways if need be, and still be game for takeoff on runways that were a mere 800 meters. By 1962, the puzzle pieces were falling into place. The jet, its heart-thumping power plant, the ejector seat that could punch the pilot out of trouble in a heartbeat, an arsenal ready for any mission, spy-worthy recon systems, ground support gear, and even simulators for virtual dogfights. February 1962 marked the thumbs up for the Viggen's blueprint, paving the way for a development contract signed in October. Renowned aviation authors Bill Gunston and Peter Gilchrist hailed it as Sweden's boldest industrial venture yet. By the 60s, the Viggen was swallowing a hefty 10% of Sweden's research and development budget. It was truly a mega project. Come 1963, Saab had the Viggen's aerodynamics dialed in, marrying an aft-mounted double delta wing with a forward-thinking canard four-plane. This was a game-changer for STOL prowess, supersonic sprints, and cruising stability. Canard designs later became the go-to for aerial agility in fighters like the Eurofighter Typhoon and the Dassault Rafale, but the Viggen was pioneering these skies first. Further tweaks included adding dogtooth notches on the wings to stir up vortices, scrapping the need for complex flaps, and banking on a thrust reverser for those runway-shortening stops. The power under the Viggen's hood was initially intended to be a British affair with the Rolls-Royce Medway. However, fate took a twist, and Saab turned to the American Pratt and Whitney JT8D, reborn as the Volvo RM8, cranked up to handle Mach 2 with a Swedish afterburner and a chameleon-like nozzle. Despite the nation's neutrality, the Viggen was shaping to be a remarkable multinational effort. Its service ceiling reached around 59,000 feet, showcasing its medium-altitude capabilities but staying well below some of the most high-flying warplanes in the world. By 1964, the first Viggen prototype was taking shape, and on February 8, 1967, it took to the skies, piloted by Eric Dahlstrom. The flight lasted a solid 43 minutes and was hailed as a marvel by Flight International. The seven prototypes each played their part in refining the Viggen, leading to a government nod in 1967 that the Viggen was a more cost-effective and superior option to the McDonnell Douglas F-4 Phantom II. By April 1968, the green light for mass production was on, with an initial order of 175 units, even as Saab explored the Viggen's maritime and photo reconnaissance capabilities. The warplane was officially named after the Swedish word Viggen, which interestingly has two meanings. The first is associated with Askvig, or Thunderbolt, inspired by Norse folklore. The second meaning refers to the Vig, translating to a tufted duck in English, which humorously ties back to the aircraft's canard configuration, as canard is French for duck. The Viggen made its grand entrance at the Paris Air Show in May 1969, stealing the spotlight as a formidable warbird. Stretching to a length of 53.80 feet, boasting a wingspan of 34.78 feet, and flaunting its distinctive canard design, she was the center of attention, turning heads left and right at the show. Soon, Saab followed up, delivering the first SK-37 trainer in 1972 and introducing the SEF-37 tactical reconnaissance variant in 1973. The quest for an all-weather interceptor led to the development of the JA-37 Viggen, answering the call for a robust air defense. This version brought to the table an updated airframe, a beefier RM-8B engine, cutting-edge electronics, and a revised armament layout, notably featuring a more pronounced tail fin and an under-fuselage gun pack. The JA-37's maiden flight in November 1977 marked its entry into operational trials, culminating in its service introduction in 1979, standing as Europe's most advanced fighter at the time. From the beginning of the Viggen's development, Saab made the trailblazing decision to design the fighter as a single-seater, banking on advanced avionics to shoulder the workload traditionally assigned to a human navigator. Sweden's foreign policy and interior policies also shaped this decision, With a fraction of the manpower some other larger nations had, every Swede airman was an invaluable asset, and if a navigation computer could take one of them from harm's way, that would be the path to take. The integration of a digital central computer and a head-up display meant the Viggen could fly solo without sacrificing precision or capability. This computer, known as the CK-37, was the first of its kind to harness integrated circuits head and shoulders above the clunky analog systems of other planes around the world. Developed by Data Saab, this airborne system could juggle navigation, flight control, and weapon aiming tasks with unexpected reliability, allowing the pilot to focus on flight and critical decision-making. As the Viggen evolved, so did its avionics. From the JA-37 variant onwards, the aircraft boasted a more powerful computer, the Singer Kierfot SKC-2037, reborn under Saab's wing as the CD-107. This leap in computing prowess wasn't just about flying faster or hitting harder. It laid the groundwork for the revolutionary avionics that would later define the Saab JS-39 Gripen. At the heart of the Viggen's sensing capabilities was the Ericsson PS-37 radar, a remarkable system highly efficient in air-to-ground and air-to-air tracking, not to mention terrain avoidance and mapping. The Viggen was a fortress of digital and mechanical innovation in the cockpit, from its Garaday Research Central Air Data Computer to the Tactical Instrument Landing System that made every landing a precision affair. Flexing its muscles as a bulwark against Soviet brinkmanship, the Viggen was kitted out to tote a devastating arsenal. This warbird could lug up to 7,000 kilograms of ordnance across 9 hardpoints, including a centerline pylon, a duo on the fuselage, quartets on the wings, and a pair nestled behind the wing's landing gear for those extra surprises. These hardpoints could accommodate air-to-air missiles like the Skyflash for beyond visual range (BVR) engagements and the shorter range Sidewinder for close combat. It also featured a single 30mm Oerlikon KCA cannon with 125 rounds for close engagement. Additionally, it was equipped with hardpoints under the wings and fuselage to carry various weapons. Ground crews had to dial in the munitions load through a selector panel, letting the Viggen's brain optimize everything from fire control to fuel burn. By 74, the Viggen was earning stripes for its reliability and toughness, flying in the face of skeptics who doubted its complex, cutting-edge systems. Yet flying low and fast on attack runs, pilots had to keep a sharp eye on another hazard, birds. The Swedish Air Force, wise to the risks, kept tabs on avian migrations to dodge feathery fiascos. In the twilight years of the 1980s, the Swedish Viggen jet finally hit its stride, its cutting-edge avionics ready for the ultimate challenge. With the Cold War's simmering tensions but no direct combat between the West and the Soviets, Swedish Viggen pilots set their sights on friendly competitions to sharpen their claws. Remarkably, they set their crosshairs on the Lockheed SR-71 Blackbird, the Cold War's sky-high queen of stealth and speed. Leveraging ground-based radar hints, the Viggens managed to clinch radar locks on the elusive Blackbird, outmaneuvering its high-speed evasions and sophisticated electronic countermeasures. Despite the odds, lacking the Blackbird's blistering speed and soaring altitude, the Viggens' advanced data links, meticulous mission planning, and the sheer piloting prowess of the Swedish aces turned the tide. The early encounters saw the Viggen's missile locks foiled by the SR-71's electronic wizardry, yet the Swedes doubled down, refining their countermeasures to consistently achieve missile locks on history's fastest jet. Swedish Air Force Viggen pilot Per-Olof Eld shared, quote, "In total I have 5 hot intercepts against the SR-71 to my credit. I was visual 3 times. On a couple of occasions, the SR-71 was contrailing, which was very useful because you could do a visual check to ensure you ended up in the right spot." These high-stakes games of cat and mouse underscored the Viggen's capability to lock on to one of the period's most elusive assets, marking it as the only foreign aircraft able to target one of America's top-tier reconnaissance jets. This unique knack for engaging the SR-71 Blackbird not only showcased the Viggen's prowess, but eventually played a pivotal role in saving it. The Viggen's unique capabilities came to a dramatic head on June 29, 1987. American airmen Dwayne Knoll and Tom Veltri were cruising above the Baltic at Mach 3 and 75,000 feet in their SR-71 when disaster struck. An engine blowout, sending them spiraling toward the Soviet Union's doorstep. With clockwork precision, Swedish Viggens, having shadowed the American spy plane, swooped in for the save. As the crippled Blackbird plummeted to 25,000 feet, the situation was dire. Soviet jets frequently breached Swedish airspace, and the downed Blackbird was a trophy ripe for the taking. The SR-71 crew was acutely aware of their peril. Tom Veltri aboard the Blackbird captured the gravity of their plight. Quote, "We did not know who would find us first. Seeing the Swedish plane escorting us was a pure liberation. I'm absolutely sure that the Swedish presence meant that other interceptors were at a distance and could not therefore come to intercept us." This act of valor sealed the Viggen's reputation as a formidable force in the skies, its technological marvels standing shoulder to shoulder with the world's elite fighters. Although the Viggen never clashed directly with Soviet forces, its legacy was forged in countless quick reaction alert scrambles throughout the 70s and 80s. In these hair-trigger showdowns, the Viggen was a bulwark against Soviet incursions, a testament to its pilots and crew's swift, agile, and vigilant defense of Sweden's airspace.